Hello, radiographers. Hope you are doing good. MRI lumbo-saccral spine is the most common MRI doctor advises. So in this video tutorial, I will show you the proper planning and technique and filming of the MRI lumbo-saccral spine. So let's do the MRI with you. So first, register the patient and go to patient and select register and enter the name of the patient and then the patient ID and then the sex and then height and then wait. And the referring physician is not compulsory, but you can set it. But you should fill up the bold letters and the patient position at the head first, supine. So now click the exam and select L spine and MMS. And L is spine, poly spine. And now select the L is spine, poly spine. And the scan is start. And look at there is a three protocols. First, the HAST localizer, and then HAST localizer, and then another HAST localizer. And these three localizer is for the cervical, dorsal, and lumbar. The first one is for the cervical localizer, and the second one is the dorsal localizer, and the third one is the lumbar localizer. So the cervical localizer scan has completed, and cervical localizer images is shown. And always look at this corner, that what's happening in the scanner. And now the dorsal localizer is scanning. And if this SAR limit comes, always keep it on the normal mode. And now I am planning for the cervical spine because we take whole spine first and then plan the lumbar spine. And for whole spine, we have to plan the cervical spine, dorsal spine, and lumbar spine. And then these three spines will compose together to make an whole spine. So now I'm planning for the distal sagittal cervical spine. And always press OK if this notification comes. I'm planning for cervical spine, and this is the first step of the whole spine. And all the three localizers is complete, the cervical, dorsal, and lumbar. So that a whole spine localizer has shown here. And now I am planning for the dorsal spine sagittal. I'm planning for this dorsal spine to make the whole spine. And this is the second step of the whole spine. And now I'm planning the slice on the dorsal spine. The slices will be parallel to the dorsal spinal cord. And make sure that the mid slice goes through the mid dorsal spinal cord, and if complete, then click this correct sign or apply. And I will now load the lumbar spine localizer for planning the T2 sagittal lumbar spine. We place the saturation band in front of the lumbar spine. First, I am setting the field of view and the other things and the saturation band on the sagittal image. Now I open the coronal image. At the first window, I keep the sagittal image, and on the middle window, I keep the coronal image. And after setting the slices, I click the apply. And the cervical spine sagittal has completed. And now the dorsal spine is running. This black line indicates that this protocol is running. And I plan the T2 sagittal lumbar, and T1 sagittal has copied this plan from the T2 sagittal. So we don't need to plan the T1 sagittal. Because all the cervical, dorsal, and lumbar protocols have completed, the software automatically gives a whole spine image, automatically composes these three protocols, and gives us a whole spine. And now I am planning for the T2 axial, T2 transverse lumbar spine. Because I already get the T2 sagittal lumbar spine from the sixth protocol. And now I am planning for the T2 axial or transverse lumbar spine. So the slices will be on the intervertebral disc, and I generally make three slices on every intervertebral disc on L5S1. I give three slices, and each intervertebral disc, over each intervertebral disc, we give three slices, and a one slice in just in D12 and L1, because we have to make 19 slices so that we can print on the 20 format in the film. So there is 19 slices, and after planning the slices properly, click the right button and select series, and again click the right button and then deselect all, and again the right button and select perpendicular, and then click apply. And now this T2 axial and T1 axial has completed planning. And now the coronal myelogram, T2 coronal and sagittal myelogram. So myelogram is a one slice, one thick slice. The slice thickness is 50 millimeter. So I am now planning for coronal myelogram on the sagittal image. So the slice will be on the spinal cord. And I also check the coronal image on the lumbar spine so that the And this is the sagittal plan I am planning on the coronal image. And this is the coronal plan I am planning on the sagittal image. So all the plan has completed now, and just the scanning running. And now I'm going to print the images, and first time I will check the whole spine, that the whole spine is correct, because the mid spinal cord is very well shown So I will crop this image from the tools and select the shutter, and I will crop this whole spine. I crop this whole spine and send it to the film sheet. And then I will select the T2 sagittal lumbar spine, the select series, and then I will crop the series from tools and select shutter and cropping the series, and then send to film. So in the filming, I go to filming and then select the whole film and change the layout to the team 4. And this team 4 layout gives us a long box for whole spine. I will pop out the reference image. And there is a two fill. I will cut out the last image. There is two extra images, so I will first delete the first image and the last image so that the one film is printed. And then I will select the lumbar spine images and zoom in to set the images properly in the box. So in the team 4 layout, I will get a whole spine box so that all the spine is set here. And this warning comes, and then click OK in the normal mode. So set the window of the fin, and if complete, then click this button, expose film tags, and the film printed. And then select the T1 sagittal image, select series, and adjust the window. And then from the tools and shutter, crop the series. And now send to the film and go to filming and select the film and then layout and select the team 3 layout or Milo. I select Milo because there is a one large box for the one a large image, and the copy the middle image so that the image is pasted here. So I'll copy the middle image and paste here, and I zoom in the image and select the rest of the image and select on succeeding and zoom in. So I am adjusting the images in the box and set up the window, the brightness of the image, and now I printed the image. And here the T2 axial is completed and the T1 axial is running. So I will select the T2 axial series. I'm checking the images and setting the window. The select series, I send it to the film and the reference image. And copying the reference image and send it to the film. And go to filming and then select the film. and minimize the text by selecting this and zoom in the Excel images. And now set the reference image, zoom out and remove the reference image of the reference image. And there is a reference image of the reference image. So delete it, no need of this. And now print out this screen. And now the T1 Excel, checking the image, and the myelogram is running. T1 Excel is completed. Select series and send it to the film. And in filming, it comes. And now select this position display and the reference image will pop out. And you can crop this image from the tools and shutter. So after cropping, send it to the film. And now go to filming. So adjust the images. So zoom in as required and adjust the reference image and remove the reference image of the reference image by properties and reference image. And the first image, keep all the information of the patient and adjust the window and print out the film. Now check the film status that this patient Hafiz has printed 4 films. And the myelogram is completed. So you can check the myelogram. So I drag the myelogram, that there's the myelogram of lumbo-saccral, which is a sagittal myelogram, and this is a coronal myelogram. So hope you enjoyed the video, learned many things.